Mr. Chairperson, Director General, distinguished delegates. At the outset, let me echo words of appreciation for the outgoing chairperson, Ambassador Dr. Christoph Isrank of Germany, and welcome in this distinguished function, Ambassador Abdel Wahab Belouki of Morocco. I wish to assure you, Excellency, of the Polish delegation's support for your efforts in the months to come. Mr. Chairperson, aligning with the EU statement, I would like to address some issues particularly important for my country. As defined by founding fathers of the Convention, the Conference of States Parties, the highest decision-making body of the organization, has special responsibilities. Bearing this in mind, we have to deal with fundamental challenges for the OPCW related to use of chemical weapons. At the same time, we have also to set scene for process leading us to the review conference next year. This is a must to enhance the OPCW credibility and adapt it to the unpredictable future. Let me elaborate on this in three brief points. Firstly, on the eve of 20th anniversary, international community is still remote from the ambitious idea of world free of chemical weapons. There are, of course, significant achievements that have to be praised. 192 state parties covering 98 global population have joined the convention. Progress in elimination of chemical weapons is indisputable. Just to mention the Libyan case or the recent remarkable example of the full destruction of chemical weapons declared by the Russian Federation. Despite all this, the last developments have drawn a pessimistic picture, the bedrock of the Convention. International norm against use of chemical weapons is being openly and fundamentally undermined. It raises questions of the Convention's integrity and the OPCW credibility. Can we agree to it? The position of the Polish government is crystal clear in this regard. We condemn in the strongest possible terms the use of chemical weapons, including those recently confirmed by the OPCW-UN Joint Investigative Mechanism related to the release of sarin at Khan Shaykhun in 2017 and the use of sulfur mustard at Umhush in 2016. We demand that the perpetrators immediately desist from any further use of chemical weapons and call them to be held to account. We support appropriate actions to address this situation. In the ongoing discussions, we shall do our utmost to stop weakening of the whole chemical disarmament and non-proliferation regime. In longer term, to pave the way to rebuild and to enhance it. This is the message we have to convey whilst gathering at the main entrance of the OPCW headquarters on November 13th to 30th to pay tribute to victims of chemical warfare of the past and of the present. Secondly, this situation has an impact on discussion on the preparation of the review conference in 2018. Last year, from this place, the Polish delegation stressed the need for a kind of four C's approach related to credibility, continuity, capabilities, and cooperation. This should be a driving force of our consideration while we will review the convention and set the strategic guidance for its future, primarily within the framework of the designated bodies for the REFCOM preparation. Poland will support these efforts to the biggest possible extent. We will pay a special attention to such issues as decreasing chemical threat, promoting international cooperation, and enhancing chemical security and safety. As raised many times before at various fora, there is also a need to consider the OPCW role as a platform for voluntary consultations and collaboration on a set of other issues related to scope and objective of the convention. See dumped chemical weapons and central nervous system acting chemicals are good examples. Mr. Chairperson, thirdly, our future success depends upon the overall united support of the international community for the world free of chemical weapons. This is exactly why Poland, similarly to previous years, presented as its soloist sponsor the United Nations General Assembly draft resolution on the CWC implementation. For years, the resolution has contributed to international peace and security. It has been enhancing chemical non-proliferation regime that is based upon the convention and its implementation body, the OPCW. This is what we need also today, even more than ever. The resolution has been adopted by the UNGA First Committee in November with enormous support of state parties. Poland was doing its utmost to address situation in a balanced manner through open and transparent process. We are convinced that the UN General Assembly in December will recognize the role of resolution and provide a coherent signal of support for the Convention and CWC in this demanding time. Let me now finish my statement in Spanish. Por último, me gustaría aprovechar esa oportunidad para expresar la satisfacción del gobierno polaco por la recomendación consensuada del Consejo Ejecutivo para la Conferencia de los Estados Partes sobre el nombramiento del excelentísimo señor embajador de España, don Fernando Arias González, para el puesto del nuevo director general. Aunque llevo escasos dos meses como representante de Polonia ante la OPAC, ya he tenido el honor de conocerle personalmente. Lo que más valoro es su disposición, su talento y su determinación para desempeñar esa ardua tarea que, sin duda, no lo será menos en los próximos años, tal y como lo he señalado previamente. Le aseguro, Excelencia, que puede contar con el apoyo de las autoridades polacas. Muchas gracias. Thank you.